While sitting to probe the Auditor General's report for the financial year 2020-2021 regarding the National Council of Sports, members of the Public Accounts Committee registered their worries over the increased death threats towards legislators on the committee, which escalated last week when the Uganda Netball Federation President, Sarah Babide Chityo, who is on sport over missing accountabilities, was remanded to Luzira Prison. The vice chairperson of PAC, Asman Basalirwa, noted that one perpetrator has been arrested.
The person said the people you are working for have security, and you don't have security. And we know you stay in Kawempe. Fortunately, I got this number and handed it over to our security team. They investigated, they traced the person.
MPs wondered why death threats went against them, yet the case which dragged Chityo to prison is not anywhere related to the matter being investigated by the Public Accounts Committee.
Some calls have come even of threats to some of our members. So the chair is not saying this. They have come. So immediately the prison thing came up. The calls were coming negatively on our sides here.
The president, I think it is incumbent upon you to explain to your supporters that the issues are not related. We are yet to come to a conclusion on these matters that are before us. So it's my appeal that please do not mix the two issues.
Chityo, who has been weeping before the committee, distanced herself from the alleged death threats to MPs, saying it must be perpetrated by her enemies who want to taint her image before the committee.
Just like you are aware, you cannot go to Luzira and you go with a phone. So it's not that I really mobilized anyone. I didn't have a hand in this.
Chityo took on the Minister of State for Sports, Peter Ogwang, and accused him of siding with National Council of Sports officials, to which Hunter, a claim which Ogwang denied.
The matters we're discussing, Mr. Chairman, I also want you to come out explicit. What is the matter which made that be taken to prison? Is it related to this current ongoing investigations? Or it is outside any matter within the docket of sports? That should also be made clear.
On several occasions, we've heard him pinning federations, even when he was new as 2 weeks. Before he understood the sector and the challenges, he was already taking sides.
Meanwhile, the committee quizzed Chityo and National Council of Sports General Secretary Bernard Ogwell over accountability of 186 million shillings, which was disbursed to Uganda Netball Federation for preparation and participation of the She Cranes in the 2021 Pent Series and Africa Netball Championship, respectively, in Namibia, held on 29th October and 17th November 2021.
Was there accountability or not for these funds?
Chair, accountability was provided, but was queried.
Okay. So what was provided by Netball Federation is what we have. We have a copy on the basis of the Auditor General.
In the review, they found that 139 million, which was supposed to be for accommodation, had issues. Because, Chair, in the middle, when there were other issues that came as a result of governance challenges in the Federation, there were a list of petitions that came.
I shared with him this letter. The letter that National Council of Sports presented here, the letter that was indicating of me being given 425 millions. I heard Dr. Ogwell explaining that letter, and he said it was a typo. Honorable Chair, I find it funny for the typo to appear all throughout.
According to what is on record, accommodation was supposed to be provided by the hosts. Now, you, as the Federation and National Council, you presented receipts indicating that you had receipts for accommodation.
Chityo also disowned most of the documents submitted by Dr. Ogwell, saying there is a lot of witch hunt when it comes to accountability of Uganda Netball Federation.
Honorable Chair, like I said earlier, it was the federation that wrote. Therefore, the person that wrote was the treasurer, Hajat Aida Nambosi, on behalf of the federation.
It's at this point that Honorable Basalirwa ruled that the contested documents be subjected to Criminal Investigation Department and handwriting experts to rule out any cases of forgery. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.